Instagram was because of squirrel pictures. They started taking down my squirrel pictures.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I know.
So I said,
now why is that? So Instagram took it down just because you put it up as a meat, as a as a edible.
Yeah. And it's like, dude,
people, they say cruelty to animals.
Yeah, that's,
well, that's fucking insane.
That's bullshit.
If you need the animal, if you're eating the animal to live, or you're eating the animal.
That's what I'm saying. And you know, people post pictures of cheeseburgers,
yeah,
and steaks and all this shit. Guess what? You know, I don't care what kind of world you live in, a fucking fantasy world, they fucking killed a cow to get that steak, to get that burger. And not only did they kill it, I killed them squirrels in about 2 seconds and they lived a natural life.
And how do you kill them? Rear naked choke? What do you do with them?
Well, if it was a deer, I'd rear naked choke it. Actually,
I'd love to see you get on that little, get on a squirrel though, with that real small, like an arm bar him.
Man, the last deer I killed, I rear naked choked it, man.
Yeah.
I didn't even shoot it. I mean, no bullshit.
And did you sneak up on it?
Yeah. It was a doe. It was sleeping. It was about a 3-hour ordeal. You know, I was sitting up in a deer stand. I called this doe in. Everybody says the doe was retarded or had
something's
some CWD. I'm telling you, it was a perfectly healthy doe. I just got its ass. You know, I waited. I was patient, and I got really lucky. It wasn't just so much skill.
Mm-hmm.
It was a lot of luck.
Mm-hmm.
But what happened is I was calling in this doe, and lays down in front of me, goes to sleep, and I shoot at it with my crossbow, and I missed. And it only had one bolt.
And it didn't move?
It got up and looked around. It like looked it. But them crossbows, it's not like a gun. It just sounds like a branch breaking. You know, so it got up and it looked around and it went right back to sleep.
Oh, lazy, huh?
Yeah, lazy, man. And,
must have been Sunday or must have been day off.
Dude, it's just my lucky day, man. I was just meant to get that deer, I'm telling you, because I just had the feeling. I was like, I visualized getting it because it was, like I said, I called it in for 3 hours, and I really had to piss, and I really had, there was this little protein cookie sitting right by me in the deer stand. I knew I wanted to take a piss, and I wanted to eat that cookie.
Yeah.
I was like, man, if you piss, that deer's going to smell it. If you reach for that cookie, the wrapper's going to make a noise. I was like, you can just, so for 3 hours, I'm sitting there just staring at this deer, not moving. It's cold. I finally shoot and I miss, and dude, is the most disappointing feeling ever. Mm. And I instantly thought, man, this deer's gonna get away. I didn't get no meat on my table.
And when it went back to sleep, then how did you make that move?
I thought, well, I'm gonna try some crazy shit. And I started making my way down to the deer. I started making my way down a deer stand.
You tiptoe? You rollerblade?
Bro, that's the definition of tiptoe. Oh, I'm walking like an Indian,
on
bro.
The tops.
Yeah. Well, I get halfway down a deer stand, and I start thinking, why don't I just grab my hatchet? Because I could chop it, but I'm already halfway down deer stand.
So you're not going back.
Too late.
Yeah.
And then I start thinking, you know what? I'm better with my bare hands because that's what I do for a living. So I start thinking, okay, I'm going to get this doe. And there's a dead tree pointing at it. So that dead tree, it was probably about 35 yards away, 40 yards away when I started. There's a dead tree pointing at it.
Mm-hmm.
So I walked the whole length of that dead tree, you know, that.
Mm-hmm.
No noise at all.
Right, real quiet.
Real, couldn't hear me.
Yeah.
Couldn't, I mean, nothing could hear me. So now I'm up close to it. When I got to the end of that dead tree, I'm like from here to that window away from it. I'm thinking, I'm going to get this fucking deer.
Yeah.
I take my gloves off because I had on big, thick gloves.
Mm-hmm.
But when you get that close
to it. Oh, you can't. Yeah, you're going to have straight on the hand.
That's when the reality set in. It's like, I'm not just trying to do this shit. I'm about to get my hands on it.
Right.
So I take my gloves off.
You can't go up there all fucking just soft mitt.
No, yeah. No, you want the grip.
Yeah.
You know, so I take my gloves off. I'm like, dude, this shit's getting real. And that's when my adrenaline was just like, it felt like a fight, like a literal.
And he's still asleep?
It's a she. Yeah, she's sleeping, completely asleep.
Does that change your vibe any that it's a man or a woman you're about to attack?
No, it's all meat. Yeah. I wouldn't attack a small one, but just because it's a... it has potential to grow bigger, so you could harvest that meat later.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
But I have no, you know, you're killing something either way, whether it's a male or female. And I'm not even into the trophy hunting. I really don't care if it's the biggest buck in the world. If somebody asks, would you rather have the biggest buck ever, some 12-pointer, or, you know, three does?
Yeah.
I'll take three does. There's more meat. You know, I'm really just there for the meat. And so then it was a wet day. It rained all day before. And so especially if you're squirrel hunting or something, that's the best time to do it,
mm-hmm.
is when it's damp outside, them leaves don't crunch,
mm.
you know? So Then it fell asleep. Then to make it even more lucky, like I said, it was meant to be. It wasn't just because of my skill. It was God was giving that shit to me. He was, he wanted that food on the table. He wanted me to have that experience. And the deer fell asleep on a game trail. So it fell asleep on a damp day on a game trail. And on the game trail, that's where all these other deer were walking. So they've already crunched the leaves for me.
Oh.
So it's like there's hardly any leaves there. The few leaves that there are, it's wet. This deer cannot hear me.
This is a layup.
This is a fucking setup. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? This deer got set up. Dude.
You're thinking Chris Hansen might pop out from one of these trees. Yeah. You're like, oh.
Well, dude, I get up there on the deer. I mean, I didn't make a noise, man. It was perfect conditions. Wow. And then I text my coach. I had my phone in my pocket. I straddled the deer. When I straddled the deer, that's when I text my coach. And
it's still asleep?
Still asleep.
And you're texting?
I'm texting. Damn, and the only reason I was texting my coach is because I really thought that doe might get up and whoop my ass. It's about 100-plus pound doe. And those fuckers are strong, man. And
you can close your Postmates app at that point, dude, because you're fucking about to eat.
Oh, yeah. Well, I texted my coach. I texted him, help, help, and run. And because I didn't want to explain to him, hey, I'm about to choke out a deer. Like, he would be like,
yeah, it's what? A lot.
It's a lot. So
do they have a deer emoji? I don't even know if they have that.
They do. Well, I just text him, help, help, run, because I want him thinking I'm about to die.
Right.
So he gets there quickly as possible. So right after I sent the text, he said, okay. And shit, I hopped on that deer. I couldn't get my right hand in because the way it was laying on its right side. So I choked it with my weaker arm with choking. I put my left arm on it. And wrapped my ankles, you know, did the standard little ankle lock. You know, I couldn't do a body triangle, so I just crossed my ankles and squeezed the ever living shit out of it. And just squeezed it for about 5 minutes till my coach got there.
And did it feel good or bad?
Well, the thing was kicking so hard that I thought it was alive when he got there, and I thought that the fucker was gonna get away. You know, I really did. I mean, it was just convulsing and twitching so hard. I couldn't control its back legs at all. I had its front legs pretty good with my legs around them, and my knees was pinching, so its front legs I felt good about. And you know, I had it by the head, but them back legs, dude, they're just kicking up dirt, just panicking, just kicking up mud's flying.
Oh yeah, like a fucking angry baseball coach.
Yeah, yeah. And so coach comes over and he's like, what are you doing? He says, what are you doing? Because and I already know what he's thinking in his head, so I didn't even try to. I said I didn't fucking shoot it because I already know in his
he
head.
He thinks you shot it. You're over here just fucking around.
I said I didn't fucking shoot it, and he goes, "What?" I said, "I swear to God, I didn't shoot it." I said, "I swear to God." He said, "You're kidding." I said, "I swear to God, stab this motherfucker. He's gonna get away." Because my arm was cramping. I mean, I was squeezing it for 5 minutes, and this thing is just kicking as hard as it was when I first. It didn't slow down. It was just
not
kicking.
Not a bit. And you had to expect it was gonna start to slow down, huh?
Yeah, and it didn't. So
do you know where its windpipe is or anything? I mean,
right here.
Okay,
just same.
And
windpipe.
That's where you're on. I'm on it.
Yeah, yeah, I'm on its throat. I mean, I'm on it. I've finished most of my fights with rear naked choke. So you know, if there's one thing I can finish, it's that damn rear naked choke. And I'm doing it just like I should, but I'm just like, shit, this thing is tough as shit. You can't choke a deer, you know? Mm-hmm. And he said, what do you want me to do? And
I said, you never see deers choking each other.
Yeah. And so I'm like, you know, stab him quick, stab her. And
he said, stabbed her?
Well, he said, I don't got my knife. I said, run up to the deer stand, get my hatchet, because my hatchet was in the deer stand, the one that I forgot. So he runs up there, runs back, and he finally goes to chop its neck. And when I let go, that deer was dead. Because the head went limp. Mm-hmm. Even though the body was twitching, the head went completely limp, and it was like, you know, made like a moan that started out high, but then ended up, it's like, you know, like that was its last bit of air coming out of the lungs. So I already knew that then he chopped its neck anyway, just to make sure that it was dead.
Damn.
But but while I was choking it, I really thought the deer was alive. I didn't know till I let go that I'd already killed it.
Damn. So it could have been dead that whole time. It
probably was after about 2 minutes.
Damn, bro. Yeah. That's almost like a rodeo a little bit at that point. Like,
shit,
damn,
was wild, man. I'd pay money
to see that.
That dude, dead deer riding? Bareback dead deer riding? I'd watch it.
The shit was wild. And I know people are going to be hating on me, these animal cruelty people. Hey, that's the best way. If you're a deer, you want me to choke you to death every time. Because let me tell you what, these deer... they die no matter what. No matter if I choke them or coyotes eat them or they get old and you know, hit by cart, they're going to die. And that's the most painless way to die. That deer is probably unconscious. Trust me, I've been choked out a lot. Okay, that deer was probably unconscious in about 7 seconds, and it was waking up from a nap. Can you imagine waking up from a nap and then just basically going right back to? I mean, you're not even gonna know what's going on.
Yeah, you're barely awake. You're like, "What was that?" And then you're going to heaven.
Yeah, and I mean, I sat there, man, and like I said, God wanted me to have that meat. I sat there.
That's a layup, man.
That's what I'm saying, man. Yeah. God put that deer there for me. I said a prayer. I said, "Thank you for." Right before I took the shot. In my head, I said, God, thank you for giving this meat to me. My family needs it. I'm going to, you know, put it towards me, the kids, the girl. We're all going to eat good off this deer. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful. I take the shot and miss. Mm. God said, you're going to have to work harder than that.
Dang, bro.
Yeah.
I said, look, man.
Shit ain't easy out here, buddy.
Yeah. Oh, man, that's a beautiful story. Wow. Dude. You know what's crazy is my sister can't even read. But what does it have to do with us right now? Hope you enjoyed that video. And you can watch another, and you can watch this one, you can watch this one. Different options, different choices. Some guy just brings you one option, not this guy. Two options. Watch one. This one or this one.